Okay, welcome to another time with Sammy and Mathematics. Now, we want to discuss something very interesting, and that is the limit of a function. This is the bedrock or the foundation of a very large concept or a very large area of mathematics, which we call derivatives, integration, differentiation, and so on and so forth, which we refer to as calculus. To really understand this, we must understand the limit of a function. Now, what we want to discuss is very, very interesting, but I must come from a very clearer or very simple way where everybody can have a good understanding of that. Now, imagine this big-headed man with probably some tiny legs this way, and imagine a very mighty pit, probably endless pit here. So if this man is going to be walking towards this place, at a certain part he has to. So he doesn't fall into this pit, he has to stop at this point and probably go back or something. This man is referred to as f of x. As he keeps walking towards this place is called limit. This place that he does not have to exceed is referred to as the limit of the function. And I can maybe refer to his legs as x. So his x is also approaching a. So the number of footsteps is also approaching a. So what we are trying to say in mathematics is that this man must not exceed this position. If he exceeds this position, he's going to fall down into this pit. And let's call this man f of x. Now this is an analogy. Let us look at the analogy in a graphical or probably a tabular form. Now you have x values going 1, 2, 3, 4, definitely to infinity. And we also have a particular function here, f of x, which is 1 over x. We have another function here, which is x squared plus 1. Now I'm going to substitute these values in it. See what we have. This is going to give us 1.002 decimal places. This is going to give us 0.50. This is going to give us 0.33. This is going to give us 0.25. This is going to give us 0.20. And this is going to give us 0.18. You see, if we continue this way, definitely, probably we'll get to a number like, let's imagine 10,000. You're going to definitely have 0.0004. If you continue that way till a very large number, you will see that we are approaching zero. That zero is what we refer to as the limit of this function as this x approaches what? Probably infinity, because it's a very large number. On the other hand, we see that if we substitute this value here, we're going to have 2.0. I'm sorry, I can use this as a polynomial. So I have 2 here, here I have 5, here I have 10, here I have 17, here I have 26, and here I have 37. You see that this number keeps increasing and keeps increasing to a very large number here, and we are approaching infinity, which we also refer to as the limit. What are we saying in this case? We are simply saying that the limit, so this LIM is used in representing limit. So we are saying that the limit of the function f of x is approaching L as x approaches a. This is an independent variable, while this is a dependent variable. So what we are saying here is that f of x does what approaches the limit as x approaches the independent variable. For instance, limit of 1 over x as x approaches 6 is simply 0.18. And limit as x approaches, g of x, which is x squared plus 1, as x approaches 6, is simply 37. On the other hand, limit of generally f of x, as x approaches infinity, we can say that it is 0 in this first case, and in the second case, we can say that the limit as x approaches infinity of f of x is equal to infinity. So that takes us to the definition. What now we understand this expression, what is the mathematical definition of that? The mathematical definition may sound scary, but I think we can understand. So definition, the definition, mathematical definition is that given epsilon greater than zero, epsilon is a small positive number, arbitrarily small, considered to be arbitrarily small. So given epsilon greater than zero, we can find, or we can use the word for every, that's better, for every epsilon greater than zero, we can find delta, which depends on epsilon, which is also greater than zero, such that f of x minus l will be less than epsilon. That simply means that f of x gets arbitrarily close to l, using this as our difference, whenever x gets arbitrarily close to delta. Remember that delta depends on epsilon. So this is the mathematical definition telling you that this gets closer to this as this gets closer to this. So, and in my next video, I'm going to be solving a question that has to do with the limit of a function. Thank you.